Dear students, we are discussing about introductory part of biotechnology. In the last class only, we have discussed about genetic engineering and the benefits of sexual reproduction over asexual reproduction, then importance of traditional hybridization as well as the importance of the genetic engineering. Or what are the benefits of genetic engineering over traditional hybridization? These things we have already discussed. In this class, let us discuss about the recombinant DNA and about restriction enzymes. Restriction enzymes. First, let us discuss about the recombinant DNA. The recombinant DNA means DNA having the gene of interest. DNA which is introduced with gene of interest, that is called as rDNA or recombinant DNA. The first recombinant DNA, first rDNA was constructed by linking a gene which codes for antibiotic resistance. Gene which codes for antibiotic resistance means which shows resistance towards the particular type of antibiotic. Gene which encodes means which codes for antibiotic resistance with a natural plasmid of Salmonella typhi murium. Natural plasmid of Salmonella typhi murium. Salmonella typhi murium is a natural plasmid. A gene which codes for antibiotic resistance is joined with or linked with a natural plasmid of Salmonella typhi murium. Plasmids are nothing but they are self or autonomously replicating circular extrachromosomal DNA. Plasmids are self-replicating. They are self-replicating means without the help of any host or any other machinery, they are able to replicate. Self-replicating or autonomously replicating circular shaped extrachromosomal DNA. Circular shaped extrachromosomal DNA are called as plasmids. In 1972, Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer. Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer in 1972 isolated a gene which is responsible for the resistance to antibiotic by cutting out a piece of DNA from a plasmid which was responsible for the resistance to antibiotic. See, this is a plasmid. It's an extrachromosomal circular DNA. In this plasmid, a gene is present, a gene which codes for antibiotic resistance. Consider it's a gene. It's a gene or segment of the DNA which is responsible for resistant to antibiotic. This gene is resistant to antibiotic. Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer isolated this gene means like this. They cut the plasmid here, then they have isolated the gene which codes for resistance to antibiotic. This is a gene. By cutting the small piece of DNA from the plasmid, they have isolated the antibiotic resistance gene. Stanley Cohen in 1972, Cohen and Boyer isolated the antibiotic resistant gene by cutting out a piece of DNA from a plasmid which was responsible for resistance to antibiotic. DNA, cutting of DNA or DNA cutting at specific location became possible with the discovery of restriction enzymes. One can cut the DNA at particular site by the help of restriction enzymes. And these restriction enzymes are commonly called as molecular scissors. They are commonly called as molecular scissors because these enzymes are helpful to cut the DNA or to cut the plasmid at a specific point or specific locations. The cut piece of DNA was then linked with the plasmid DNA. Cut piece of the DNA, for example, consider this is the gene or piece of the DNA which is resistant to antibiotics, and this gene will be present in the DNA of particular organism. Consider this is the segment of the DNA which is responsible for resistance to antibiotic. First, we need to cut the DNA. First, we need to cut the DNA at specific point. Then, and this DNA should contain the gene of our interest. After that, this DNA or cut piece of the DNA or segment of the DNA or gene of our interest is linked to the plasmid. Now it is linked to plasmid. With the help of the enzyme DNA ligase. DNA ligase. We have already discussed about DNA ligase in DNA replication topic. DNA ligase. In DNA replication, DNA ligase helps in the attachment or joining of Okazaki fragments. DNA ligase are helpful in the joining of Okazaki fragments. Here, this DNA ligase enzyme is helpful to link the gene of our interest with the plasmid DNA. Hence, DNA ligase is called as molecular stitcher. Restriction enzymes are called as molecular scissors because restriction enzymes are helpful to cut the DNA at specific location, whereas DNA ligase enzyme is commonly called as molecular stitcher because it helps in attachment of gene of our interest with the plasmid or plasmid DNA. This DNA ligase enzyme acts on the cut DNA molecules and then they join the both the ends of the plasmid DNA as well as ends of gene of our interest. This makes a new combination of circular autonomously replicating DNA created in vitro and is known as recombinant DNA. Now this is called as recombinant DNA or rDNA. Now this is called as rDNA or recombinant DNA. DNA having a gene of our interest or DNA segment of our interest. After the joining of gene of our interest or DNA segment of our interest with the plasmid DNA by the help of DNA ligase enzyme, it is called as rDNA or recombinant DNA. And we can create the rDNA in vitro condition, in laboratory condition. When rDNA or recombinant DNA is transferred to E. coli, bacteria E. coli or Escherichia coli. E. coli is a bacteria which is closely related to Salmonella, because here we have used natural plasmid of Salmonella typhimurium. So closely related species called E. coli is used as a host. After the formation or construction of RDNA, this RDNA is transferred into E. coli cell. It is a E. coli cell. Into this E. coli cell, this plasmid DNA is transferred, or not plasmid, recombinant DNA is transferred, because here plasmid DNA as well as gene of our interest is present here. This is RDNA. Now this RDNA is introduced into E. coli. Then this RDNA replicate using the host DNA. See, this is the DNA of the E. coli. Using the host machinery, or using the host DNA polymerase enzyme, DNA polymerase enzyme of the host, this RDNA replicates and makes multiple copies. For the replication of DNA, DNA polymerase enzyme is essential. DNA polymerase enzyme catalyzes the addition of particular type of deoxyribonucleotides to the 3' end of the primer. Already we have discussed these things in DNA replication topic. By using the DNA polymerase enzyme of the host, host means here host is the E. coli. By using DNA polymerase enzyme of the E. coli, this RDNA replicates and forms multiple copies. The ability to multiply the copies of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli is called as cloning of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli. Cloning of antibiotic resistance gene. Antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli. So cloning of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli is nothing but the ability to multiply the copies of antibiotic resistance gene. See, antibiotic resistance gene is present here, forming or making multiple copies of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli is called as cloning of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli. So this is about brief introduction regarding RDNA and construction of RDNA and how RDNA forms multiple copies in the host cell. The genetic modification of an organism mainly includes four steps. The genetic modification means in the construction of transgenic plants or transgenic animals, mainly four steps are included. Genetic modification of an organism. Suppose a plant is genetically modified, then it is called as transgenic plant. If an animal is genetically modified, it is called as transgenic animal. The genetic modification of an organism. Genetic modification of an organism includes four steps. It includes four steps, such as: one is identification of DNA with desirable gene. First step is identification of DNA. Identification of DNA with desirable gene. Desirable gene means gene of our interest. Then second one is insertion of that gene into plasmid. Insertion of desirable gene into plasmid, into suitable plasmid. That is the second step. First step is identification of DNA with desirable gene or gene of interest. And second step is, after identification of the DNA, we have to cut the DNA using molecular scissors. After cutting the DNA at specific site, we have to insert that DNA or gene of our interest into the particular plasmid using DNA ligase enzyme, molecular strictures. Then third step is introduction of recombinant plasmid into host cell. Introduction of recombinant plasmid, R plasmid means recombinant plasmid, or also called as recombinant DNA, into particular host. It may be a E. coli or any host, into the host cell. Then the fourth step is maintenance of introduced gene. Fourth step is maintenance of introduced gene in the desired organism and transfer of that gene into its progeny or into daughter cells. Maintenance of introduced gene. Maintenance of introduced gene in the desired organism. Desired organism means, suppose if we have used E. coli, suppose we have transferred our DNA into E. coli, then maintenance of that rDNA, recombinant DNA, in the E. coli and transferring that rDNA into the progeny cells of the E. coli or daughter cells of E. coli. That is the fourth step of genetic modification of an organism. So these are the main four steps which comes under genetic modification of an organism. First step is identification of particular gene having gene of DNA with having gene of our interest. Next step is cutting the DNA at specific site using molecular scissor. After that, insertion of gene of our interest into particular plasmid using DNA ligase enzyme. Then introduction of recombinant plasmid or rDNA into particular host. Fourth step is maintenance of that introduced gene in the particular host, and after that transferring the particular gene or gene of interest into the its progeny. So these are the main four steps. Next one is tools of recombinant DNA technology. Tools. What are the tools of recombinant DNA technology or rDNA technology? Tools of rDNA. Tools of rDNA technology or recombinant DNA technology. What are the main requirements to construct rDNA? Requirements to construct rDNA. Various biological tools are used in order to accomplish the genetic engineering or rDNA technology. Various types of biological tools are required. The important tools are restriction enzymes. The important tools are restriction enzymes, polymerase enzymes, restriction enzymes, then polymerase enzymes, DNA ligases, DNA ligases, molecular strictures, then vectors. Vectors are nothing but vehicles. We are going to study in detail about this. Then host cell, and bioreactor. In this chapter, we are going to discuss all these things in detail one by one. First, we will discuss about restriction enzyme. Restriction enzyme. Restriction enzymes are also called as restriction endonucleases. Restriction enzymes are also called as restriction endonucleases. Restriction endonucleases. REN. REN. Restriction endonucleases or REN. Write a note on REN. Or what are restriction endonucleases? These are the cleaving enzymes, hence they are commonly called as molecular scissors. These are cleaving enzymes. Cleaving means which cuts the DNA at specific site. Hence they are commonly called as molecular scissors. Important for one mark, they'll ask reason. Why restriction endonucleases are commonly called as molecular scissors. In 1963, two restriction endonuclease enzymes were isolated. They were called restriction endonucleases because these enzymes are responsible for restricting the growth of bacteriophage in E. coli by adding methyl groups to DNA and cutting the DNA. In 1963, two restriction endonucleases were isolated. Two restriction endonucleases were isolated in 1963. They were called as restriction enzymes because those two isolated enzymes were responsible for restricting the growth of bacteriophage. They restricted the growth of bacteriophage. Bacteriophage are the viruses which infect the bacteria. Those two isolated restriction enzymes restricted the growth of bacteriophage in E. coli. In bacteria E. coli. How means they, these two restriction enzymes added methyl groups to the DNA and cut the DNA at specific site. By adding methyl group and cutting DNA at specific location, they restricted the growth of bacteriophage in E. coli. Hence, those two isolated restriction enzymes were named so. The first restriction endonuclease was discovered by Hamilton Smith. The first restriction endonuclease enzyme was discovered by Hamilton Smith, and the first restriction endonuclease was HIND2. HIND2 was the first restriction enzyme. First restriction enzyme was HIND2, and it was discovered by Hamilton Smith. It is also important for one mark. Hamilton Smith discovered the first restriction enzymes, that is HIND2, in the bacterium Haemophilus influenza. They discovered the first restriction enzyme, that is HIND2, in the bacteria Haemophilus influenza. Haemophilus influenza. And this restriction endonuclease HIND2 always cut the DNA molecules at a particular point by recognizing a specific sequence of 6 base pairs. Always this restriction enzymes cut the DNA at specific site. Always they cut the DNA at particular point by recognizing the 6 base pairs which are present in that point. The 6 base pairs are present in the DNA. By recognizing the location of the 6 base pairs or at that site only, this HIND2 restriction enzyme cut the DNA. And this specific sequence is called as recognition sequence for HIND2. For example, consider this is a DNA. and in this site, six base pairs are present. Six base pairs are present. By recognizing this six base pairs, and how these six base pairs are present, what they are called, everything we are going to discuss in next class. By recognizing this six base pairs only, at this site, HIND2 cuts the DNA. And these six base pairs are called as recognition sequence for HIND2. Till now, around 900 restriction enzymes have been isolated from more than 230 bacterial strains. So far around 900 restriction enzymes were isolated. And all the restriction enzymes recognize the different recognition sequences. Now let us discuss about the naming of restriction enzymes. How restriction enzymes were named? Naming of restriction enzymes. For example, how HIND2, restriction enzyme HIND2 was named. Okay, first three letter. See, in case of HIND2, the restriction enzyme HIND2. First one is, the first three letters, first three letter code is given for each restriction endonuclease enzyme. Then the second principle of naming the restriction enzyme includes the first letter of the restriction enzymes always refers to the genus name of the bacteria from which it is isolated. See, the naming of restriction enzyme is based on certain principles. The first principle is three letter code is given to all the restriction enzymes, endonuclease enzymes. Then the second rule is the first letter of the restriction enzyme refers to the genus name of the bacterium from which it is derived. For example, HIND2 is a restriction enzyme which is derived from the bacteria Haemophilus influenza. So the genus name is Haemophilus. Haemophilus influenza is a bacterium from which the HIND2 restriction enzyme were isolated. So in that bacterium, the genus name is Haemophilus. So the first letter of the genus name is H. So the first letter of the restriction enzyme refers to the genus name of the bacterium from which it is isolated or it is derived. And the first letter should be always, it should be capital. Then the third rule, the subsequent two letters, the next two letters represents the species name. The next two letters means second and third letter represents the next two letters or subsequent two letters represents the species name. It represents the species name. First letter represents the genus name. Subsequent two letters represents the species name. The three letters are generally written in italics. These three letters are generally written in italics. So we have to underline. For example, restriction enzyme ECO. Restriction enzyme ECO for Escherichia coli. Then the restriction enzyme HIND. Already we have discussed HIND. HIND is the restriction enzyme which is isolated from the bacteria Haemophilus influenza. Then the next rule, fourth rule. Fourth rule of the restriction, naming of restriction enzyme, fourth rule. The next letter represents the strain. The Roman number indicates the different endonucleases derived from the same organism. Means here HIND 2. This Roman number 2 indicates that already the biologists have isolated HIND 1. HIND restriction enzyme HIND 1 from the same bacteria Haemophilus influenza. The fourth letter represents the strain, type of the bacteria or type of the restriction enzyme that represents the strain. Then the Roman number which is present at the end indicates the different endonucleases derived from the same organism. Suppose biologists have isolated 5 restriction enzymes from single bacteria. Then they will give name like first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means that indicates that 5 restriction enzymes have been isolated from single bacteria. Means here HIND 2. HIND 2 represents or indicates that from the Haemophilus influenza bacteria they are isolated 2 restriction enzymes. One is HIND 1 but this is HIND 2. So, the examples for restriction enzymes, ECO-R1 or ECO-R2, means from the Escherichia coli, they were isolated 2 restriction enzymes, or you can write HIND-2, then many BAMH1, many different restriction enzymes that are there. We are going to discuss all these types in the next classes. Okay, naming of restriction enzymes is important for 3 marks. These principles which comes under naming of restriction enzymes is important for 3 marks. For this you have to explain this with by taking the example of particular restriction enzymes. Thank you.